Okay, my name is Caterina Bortolussi. I'm Italian and I am a fashion designer. As a young girl, I was, you know, like playing with clothes and I was, you know, that was always what I wanted to do. But I think that in life, sometimes you convince yourself that you should be somebody else or you should do something else because maybe life, you know, doesn't give the opportunity to you to be your dream, maybe to others. But when you realize that you must pursue your dreams because, you know, everybody has the chance. So that takes courage, but it also gives you a lot of joy. And for me, it took me a lot of years before coming into fashion. You know, I started in 2010, Kinabuti. So just 2 years ago. And, you know, it was facing, you know, my fears, facing my dreams and becoming aware that nothing would have made me happy unless I would have gone into designing clothes. Well, Kinabuti, I think that is my name. So it started with me as a kid. People were asking me, what's your name? And my name is Caterina Bortolussi, very lengthy. So when I was given my name, I was, you know, and I couldn't phrase it all. I said, Kina Caterina Buti Bortolussi. So it's always been there. But, and I knew when I moved to London and I, you know, my friend heard my mother calling me Kina and she said, I really love this name, it's very sweet, I like it. And I knew that that was gonna be the name of my label. So I had that in the back of my mind, so I knew it was gonna happen. Then I moved to Nigeria and I was doing something completely different. But I gave myself a couple of years, like, okay, do, you know, whatever you're doing, you take your time, and then in 2 years' time, you're gonna start your label. So Kinabuti came to me in 2010. We started in July with the first tailor, and in September we had the idea of making it, giving it a swing of, you know, making it a social, ethical label, which means using fashion as a vehicle to make a difference. We were inspired by a documentary, Wasteland, and to use fashion. And so we started with the project with the girls in the communities. We went to Port Harcourt, into the waterfront. We started working with the girls from these communities. We made them realize that everybody can be their dream, just as we realize ourselves. And so, you know, it's been a long journey since.
A lot of people say there's no place like home, but at Limelight Hotel & Suites, we have a place that's just like home. Limelight Hotel & Suites is located in the serene and homely countryside of Agoiwoye, Ogun State. Limelight Hotel & Suites offers you nothing but the best in hospitality and facilities that you will not find anywhere. We have 3 bars, an oriental restaurant with a guarantee of uninterrupted power supply and reliable internet facilities, not forgetting our ATM machines and POS terminals to give you the ease of cashless fun. Come relax and retreat into the calm embrace of Limelight Hotel & Suites. For more information, log on to www.limelighthotel.com or email us on info@limelighthotel.com or call us on 0807-097-1904. Limelight Hotel & Suites. Taking
very established, you know, like we've got like many years of experience, and Italy is very famous, you know, like for excellence in production. You know, we are great artisans. You know, we make amazing furniture, we make amazing food, we make amazing, you know, clothes. So, you know, if you go to Italy and wherever you go, you know, you see these beautiful churches, you see architecture is amazing. So we have that culture, you know, like that is for centuries that's been there. And Nigeria, I think, but, you know, like Italy now, although we have Armani, Cavalli, Dolce Gabbana, Valentino, it's a bit of a stagnant moment when it comes to the economy. Nigeria, I think that Nigerian fashion industry is very exciting. It's, we've got Nigerian designers known all over the world. They're making their name. I mean, just a couple of months ago, there were designers at the Pitti. Pitti is a big fair in Italy, very famous for new trends. and we had the famous Nigerian designers there. So it's not just that it's relevant within the country, it's making a name outside the country. So it's a good moment to be for the fashion industry in Nigeria. I think the difference is quality in production. And it's not because we lack talent here, but because, you know, like there are processes, there is investments that needs to be made, you know, like when it comes to Nigeria, there is no distribution, very little distribution. If you go to Italy, there are shops all over, you know, production-wise, you know, like there are big challenges. Also, there is a ban on importation of fabric. So the challenges are plenty. But the environment is right, you know, we have a Rise Fashion Week happening in Nigeria that is featured all over the world. Well, I must say, I thank God because although it has not been easy, but it has been, you know, like, we are grateful because Nigeria responds very well to our, you know, like to our clothes. They like it, it's funky, it's different. We have a good clientele. They like it, they like the flair. I think it's also because we are like under the bridge, you know, like we are based in Nigeria, but we are European. So we have that, maybe that bridge, that kind of like connection that maybe makes us unique on top. Well, when I think I am very, you know, people might describe me loud, you know, I like colors, you know, I like, and when I go, I remember I was in Italy, I think I was in my area, and went in this very beautiful city, and I was wearing my, you know, my Ankara thing, and I was going around, I said, man, thank God I'm in Nigeria, this place is boring, everybody's gray, and I said, jeez. And I think there is a lot of happiness, and that's what I like about also Nigeria, the people are happy, the people, although what they went through, I said, you can ask them, how are you? I'm good, thank God, you know, like there is a lot of appreciation, there is a lot of, you know, gratefulness. And I like that, and I think, you know, like happiness comes also through the fabrics. And so I like, you know, I like the colors, I like the prints, and it's always easy in our clothes, you know, like, and I think this is also kind of like a signature. Thank you very much for coming to the Kina Beauty House. Thank you very much for the opportunity. This is us, this is our family, and hopefully you'll see more of us, you know, in the near future. Ciao, ciao. Bye.